Well, now to be brief, let's pass over the rest, who seldom or never were given to jest, and sing of King Jamie, the first of our throne. Oh, a pleasanter monarch sure never was known. As he was out hunting the swift fallow deer, he dropped all his nobles, and when he got clear, in search of some pastime, away he did ride, till he came to an alehouse up by the woodside. And there with a tinkler he chanced for to meet, and him in kind sort so freely did greet. Pray tell me, good fellow, what hast in thy jug, which under thy arm thou dost lovingly hug? By the mass, quoth the tinkler, 'tis nappy brown ale, and for to drink to thee, friend, I'll not fail. For though that thy jacket be gallant and fine, I think that my tuppence as good is as thine. By me soul, honest fellow, 'tis truth thou hast spoke. And straight he sat down with the tinkler to joke, and they drank to the king, pledged to each other, who'd seen a mug, thought they was brother and brother. And as they were drinking, the king pleased to say, what news, honest fellow, come tell me, I pray? Well, there's nothing of news, save that I hear that the king's on the border, chasing the deer. And truly, I wish I so happy may be, whilst he's out hunting the king I might see. For though I had travelled the land many ways, I never have yet seen the king in me days. And the king did with hearty good laughter reply, by me soul, honest fellow, if thou canst but ride, thou wilt get up behind me, and thee I will bring to the presence of Jamie, thy sovereign king. Oh, but he'll be surrounded with nobles so gay, so how shall we tell him from them, sir, I pray? Well, you'll easily know him when once thou art there, for the king said be covered, but his nobles all bare. So he got up behind him, and likewise his sack, with his budget of leather and his tools at his back. And away they did ride to the merry green wood, where the nobles came around and bareheaded they stood. And the tinkler then, seeing so many appear, slyly did whisper the king in his ear, oh, they are all clothed so gloriously gay, but which amongst them is the king, sir, I pray? And the king did with hearty good laughter reply, by me soul, honest fellow, it's thou or it's I. For the rest are bareheaded, uncovered all round. And the tinkler he gaped, and he fell to the ground, and like one who was frightened quite out of his wits, down on his knees then he instantly gets, beseeching for mercy. But the king to him said, oh, you're a good fellow, so be not afraid. Come tell me thy name. I am John of the Dale. I'm a mender of kettles and a lover of ale. Well, rise up, Sir John, I will honour thee here, for I make thee a knight of 3,000 a year. Which was a fine thing for the tinkler indeed, and straight to the court he was sent for with speed, where great store of pleasure and pastime was seen, all in the royal presence of king and of queen. Now Sir John of the Dale, he has land, he has fee, at the court of the king, who so happy as he? But still in his hall hangs the tinkler's old sack, with his budget of leather and his tools in a pack, to remind of the times to his back they did cling, and the time he spent drinking with Jamie the king.